Yo, this is Big Talk, Big Game. We in the building. Sorry for the technical difficulties that we was having, but hey, man, the show must go on. Once again, each and every Thursday from 7 to 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Big Talk, Big Game is in the building. This is your boy, D-Rail.
Hey, Cal.
And I go by the name of Lee. What up?
Man, and we definitely got a great guest coming in the building today, ladies and gentlemen. The CEO of the Love Games.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. The one.
Uh-oh.
The only.
The only.
Miss Tamika Turnage, y'all.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody.
Bullet.
Hey, tell the people out there, man, that may not know about you, Mika, you know what I'm saying, about who you are and what you're about.
My name is Mika. I am the CEO, founder of Love Games. Love Games is a place where you and your person can get to know each other, love each other, communicate, competing against other couples, having a good time.
Yeah. It's
all
fun stuff,
in love.
It's
big
fun.
Big fun.
Yes, man. So, hey, so we got the CEO of Love Games in the building. She's going to definitely be spreading the love today, because today the show is about love.
Love.
You know what I'm saying? It's not about
love.
Hate. It's not about like.
Uh-huh.
It's not about lust. It's about love.
Yeah.
You love feel me? And relationships.
I lust for love.
Me too.
Hey, but before we get into love, though, you know what I'm saying? Before we get into, you know what I'm saying, Miss Tamika Turnage, you know what I'm saying, what she about and what she's going to bring for y'all today on today's show, a Big Talk, Big Game.
Uh-huh.
I have to let y'all know.
What you got
to
let us know?
Today, National Day.
What is it, man?
What is it?
It's National Apple Pie Day.
You know, and is I ate an apple.
So you know what I did for my crew?
What you do, my dog?
My guests.
Let me get some apple pies, baby.
I brought us some apple pie. I
brought
us some apple pie.
I'm fucking with it.
You feel me?
Yeah.
Oh!
You know what I'm saying? And I brought it from McDonald's, where they say the word love, where they say, we loving it.
Hey,
you know what I'm saying?
McDonald's ain't paying us no money.
How
no
you
money.
Treat
hey,
you.
Hey.
I'm fucking with that.
You know what I'm saying? So we definitely got apple pies today, man. Today is National Apple Pie Day, so I brought apple pies for each and every member, including the guests, today, man. So get your apple pie eat on, man.
I need to warm mine up in the microwave right
now. You know what I mean?
From home.
Need some water.
Hey.
So, hey, you know what I'm saying? So we definitely going to get into
National
this. National
Apple Pie Day.
We definitely going to get into the CEO of the Love Games, you know what I'm saying? Definitely, you know what I'm saying? Ask her a few questions. Get to know about, what she bringing to the table, and also get to know about her personally on a personal, deep level.
Uh-oh,
you feel me?
About to get in your business.
All in my business.
So, Miss Tamika, you know what I'm saying? You're the CEO of Love Games, you know what I'm saying? So tell the people a little bit about what it's about and what exactly is it entail, the whole Love Games.
How did you get started with it?
So here's the thing. Mm-hmm. I am the person in the family that gets the things together. Let's go to the park. Let's do this. I've always had all the sports equipment when we were children. This is my brother. When we were children, I always had the sports equipment. I'm still like that now. I also love love. So I thought, how about if we do a competitive game with each other? You bring your person, your husband, your wife, your boyfriend, girlfriend, doesn't matter. You don't have to be married. You don't have to be the most physically fit. You don't even have to be competitive. But it's just
character.
All in fun. And you're competing against other couples. But the main object is to build the communication, the trust, and the love with your partner. See, we ain't teammates. No.
Right.
You know
right.
what I mean? You're just not on your person's team.
Come on, let's wake that
me
up.
It's against you. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? And so sometimes when you compete and your goal is to accomplish something and let it be yours against other people, that's what grows your bond.
Right.
So that's what it is.
Okay.
Woo! Hey, I wish these effects was working.
Yeah, we had
bam, 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 bam.
Yeah, so we got all that. We got to do it manually, you know what I'm saying? So that's all it is. Because, I mean, I was a part of them. The rail was a part of them. They fun. I got me a victory. I got me a ring on one of them because we won. So the prizes are on point. And it was a lot of fun. So every now and then, a couple of y'all will argue, but me and Mom, we was good.
I'm glad you said that, brother. The very first time we had the games, it was a couple, they fell out right before it started, right? I don't like you, you don't like me. And so they decided, I'm going to go ahead and play anyway. I'm going to support Mika. So they came out, they communicated, and they won the whole damn thing.
Did they get back together?
They did.
Love games.
Look at love.
Putting your relationship back on track, people.
Still together.
Quit going to the therapist. Just go to love games.
That was a game.
How many times you going to go to the movies? How many times you going to go to dinner? Do something a little more active.
Yeah.
Get hot, sweaty.
Go to breakfast.
Take a shower together later. Uh-oh. You know, come on.
Go to Miss Winters.
I tub a little too small for that.
I said shower. You said tub.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's a lot of me.
This man is a cross tub.
She'll be standing under the rain.
You might just need a wash up.
Baby, wash me up. Real
get you a wash up together.
Oh, man.
So as far as you don't say your love games, are you trying to take this nationwide, or because I know it's
local
right now?
I'm trying to take
right
it
now.
As far as it can go. So yes, ultimately nationwide. I'm trying to be on TV, like a game show.
I mean,
because
I can see that as a game show.
You know what I mean? Yeah. You have what's the ones, the ultimate so-and-so's, when the people running through the obstacle courses and stuff like that.
Wipeout.
Yeah, that kind of stuff. You know what I mean?
That's awesome. So, or do you want to be like Love Connection?
Not necessarily Love Connection, maybe a little bit of both, because I am going to do a singles one in September.
Oh,
so
what?
All the single women and men, I got
where my
you.
Ladies at?
Hey, y'all know who y'all are. Single ladies, single men, y'all know who y'all are. Y'all always calling up here trying to look for love. Here's the time right now. Here you go. We got Big Talk,
Man.
Big Game.
Yes, a lot of people
even if you
play.
Big Talk, Big Single. We got you in September.
A lot of people want to play, but they don't have a partner. Mm. So we're going to do a single one.
Whoa. Yeah, you tired of playing with yourself? We're going to have a single one.
So you might have like the single man, single, you're just going to pair them up. Or like,
so what I'm going to do is, since you know, I'm going to tell just y'all three. Okay.
And I ain't going to
what you're
going to
do
nobody.
Is, there will be a series of games, and each game, I'm going to yell, switch. So you're going to play a different game with a different person every time.
Oh, that's
at the end of the night, you're going to let me know your top two choices.
Mm.
I will then match you together, and the next day you'll find out who you're going to play with to develop a closer bond.
Oh, that's lit. That's bam, 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 bam.
You
that's
know,
lit. That's dope.
So that's how like a love connection.
Damn.
Love
that's
game.
Right.
Hey, it might be a couple of salty people like, damn, I chose.
Yeah.
He ain't know what the other.
But they not gonna know who chose who.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
I can see that being on Netflix. That's lit. That's dope.
Yeah.
That'll be fun to watch.
I'm excited about it. Excited about it. Yeah.
So you know what I'm saying? So you the CEO of Love Games.
Yes.
So what actually does love mean to you, since you the one that runs the whole show? What does it mean to you?
Love to me is unconditional. Love to me is friendship, fun, partnership. Love to me is sweet. It's sexy when it wanna be. This is my brother, so you know I ain't gonna get too.
Please don't.
However, and my cousin, my brother and my cousin, and they don't even know all that. However, love is beautiful. I love love. I love relationships. Which is why I am now a certified relationship coach.
All right.
Yes. So whether you have a relationship with a friend, a relationship with your parent, relationship with your sibling, communication, mutual respect, and love is important.
Yeah. Because, you know, God is love.
Wow.
And you get that connection with God, you got loving.
Absolutely right. So you sign up, you wear matching shirts.
Okay,
that
so
shows
matching
your
shirts
unity.
Come with.
Yes,
okay.
Your shows your unity. You'll give me a number. You know, your number can represent whatever you want it to be. For example, mine is 777. Me and my husband, hey Noni, got married July 7th at 7 p.m.
Oh, wow. That's
so good. You can put whatever number represents you. Then we're going to do a little eating. We're going to do a little drinking.
Oh, we in there.
Overall good time.
Oh, man. So we're going to be some drunk loves.
A little bit.
Like Beyonce
drunk
said.
Love.
Drunk in love.
That makes it even more interesting.
Right,
yes.
Right.
Yes.
Right. So that we're going to be in the pool and the water and everything like that?
Now, hold on. I don't need no lawsuit because you can't swim. So,
sign a disclaimer.
Oh, yeah. There's a waiver. Yeah. So when you go on the website, www.lovegames777.com, you'll see the waiver. www.lovegames777.com.
Okay. So if you want to sign up, like she said, it's www.lovegames777.com. 777.com.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Straight like that.
Hey, and you got time. This is the time that we actually bringing it to y'all today, live on air with Big Talk, Big Game.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We're bringing y'all a love game. The love is here. All we can do is spread it.
That's
spread
all
it
we
to
can
you.
Do.
Spread it to us. Spread it to the whole world. And I guarantee you, you will feel better about yourself inside and
it's
out.
It's springtime, man. Love is in the air.
And
left, anyway.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, we talking about love. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And you said love is unconditional.
Yes.
But as far as you, if you had to use the words of love or unconditional or, you know, whatever other words that go with the word love, what's one word that would describe you talking about the topic we're talking about right now?
One word?
Because you're the CEO of love.
Hold on. Mm-hmm. Say the question again.
It was loaded.
So we're talking about love.
We're talking about love.
If you had to use any word that links up with the word love and unconditional.
To describe you as a lover?
Yeah.
Okay.
One word that would describe you.
I'm going to say passion. Okay?
Okay.
When I am into something, whether it's a person, a thing, passion is what drives me. Because no matter what it is, no matter what happens on the outside, I'm in there. Once I love you, I love you. And that's it.
That's lit. What about you? What about you?
You going to put me on the spot?
One word.
Just to give him some more time to think. That's all it is, bro. That's all.
What up, E?
For me, damn. Passion was a good one.
Wasn't it, though?
See, mine is, my love, damn, it's running along the same lines. I was going to say loyalty.
Mm. Ooh, okay.
Because for me, that loyalty says a lot. Actually, this kind of goes into a little bit of my rankum a little bit. But loyalty says a lot as far as when you bring it to the table with your partner, that trust, that commitment is a strong part of your love.
Yes.
You know, because once you commit and have that loyalty and that's that person, then you and that person are connected. And then that's when you kind of draw to each other regardless of what's going on.
So absolutely.
That goes into the unconditional part. Regardless of what's going on, you loyal to that person until you break that loyalty.
What about you, Darrell? Yeah, throwing it all away.
And I ain't going to lie to you. I was over here thinking about a word. They took some very good words.
Yeah, they did. I did.
Come on, brother. Goodness.
Come on, Family Feud.
Oh, my goodness. The word love. I would probably say...
Wouldn't you have an answer in mind if you was asking the question? I mean, didn't he ask this question?
He did. Wow. Yeah, you know.
But you know how it is. I didn't think you was going to get in depth
into
it.
Reverse that thing. Put the reverse card out there.
Toss it back, Darrell. Toss it back.
Man, I'm going to toss it back on you real quick and start thinking about it, man.
Oh, ain't no problem, man. See,
he had time to think about it.
Exactly. So I'm going to go ahead and say communication.
That's a good one.
Okay.
That's a good answer.
Because you need communication in whatever you're doing. You know what I'm saying? It takes communication to show love. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And without communication, the love is invalid. Come on, somebody.
Come on now.
All right.
You got to express.
You have to express what you feel about what you say.
Come on now.
And when you say it, it has to be shown in your tone.
Talk to him now.
See, I don't think y'all hear me. See, I said communication is what will lead you to your true love.
All right.
And if you want to hold, if you want to plead, then you got to communicate.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
And on that note, I'm going to toss it right back to Darrell.
Well, you know what?
I'm
going to tell y'all right now. I think I got the word. I'm going to go with trust.
Mm.
Okay.
You know, because you can't have love without trust.
It is.
You know what I'm saying? And you can't have trust without love. Because how you going to love somebody if you don't trust them? You know what I'm saying? How you going to be able to trust somebody?
It's somebody with that issue right
now. I'm about to say.
Right. How you going to trust somebody if you don't love them? You know what I'm saying? So they work hand in hand. And
you know
I feel
what they
like.
They say, it ain't that I don't trust you.
I don't trust these bitches. Right here. And that's some bullshit.
And that means you don't trust me.
That's some bullshit right there.
Because you think I ain't got the willpower to turn down his
heart.
Come on now.
So if you don't trust me, then obviously you don't love me like you should be.
You don't love me.
Because when I got down on one knee,
I
said, would you marry me?
He's still tall.
Hey.
Hey.
So you gotta understand.
I didn't get that one in. Didn't move. His hand was still right here, lined up with the mic. Like, damn. Kanye say, how you stay faithful in a room full of hoes? Easy. Hey. Easy, Kanye.
I closed my eyes.
Hey, this is about love, y'all. What up, Tony? Tony, love. This is about love, Tony. What
Tell
up?
Me what you what know
up?
About it.
This is about love, you feel me?
So let me ask you this. Since yes. we own yes. the word love and the subject love, uh-huh. what's the difference between being in love and Ooh. Having love for somebody?
That's a good one.
Because, you know, you can have love for someone and, you know, you care about their well-being. But when you're in love, your desire is to make them happy. Mm-hmm. Right? You're in love with them. It doesn't matter what it is going on. You want them to be happy, even when you mad at them.
Yeah.
If you pissed off at them, but you still like, oh, fine, give me the goddamn hug. You know what I mean? You love. You know what I mean?
Y'all want, you want some meat?
You know? You test the waters, yeah, right? Yeah. When you done broke up, but you still... You're not going out here getting no new numbers.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because you're just mad at the time, but you still love them.
Right.
If
right.
you just got love for somebody, hey. I could take it or leave it. You hey, know what I'm saying?
What's up, Crystal?
Somebody said you better tread lightly.
I don't know how to do that, somebody.
Right, there you go. We walk hard.
Who is that? Man. How you do that?
Hey, yo, him. He said you better tread lightly.
You know I don't work well with you, Ben. You know I don't know well. I don't do well with that kind of stuff. He know it.
He know what
he
is.
Know it.
He know the
because he know me, you know what right?
I'm so
that's another thing. You got to know.
Oh, yeah.
Who you dealing with?
Yeah, let's wake that up.
Yeah. It be so many people.
You got to.
I ain't gonna say no names around here. Yeah. But it be so
at
many
least
people.
You gonna be like tread lightly.
Better come tell me. You ever have a homeboy, you know what I'm saying, and they girl come to you and be like, man, what's up with your boy? He da da da. Nigga, I been knew that he was like that. Ain't you in a relationship with him?
But
you ought to know.
Low key, you did know.
Yeah.
You just chose to overlook.
And see, that's
what
thing.
It is. That's
you
what love
know,
does.
You gotta know, acknowledge, and recognize what's going on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, that's all it
yeah.
is.
Yeah. That's yeah. another
Sherelle,
thing.
Up?
If you can love somebody through the that bullshit you don't like about them,
uh-huh.
yeah.
then you love them. Like,
yeah.
for real.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah. this motherfucker
yeah.
got
yeah.
hairy
yeah,
toes.
Because y'all
but
know,
I love
y'all
I love
know
them.
Who I'm married yeah. to. We are completely different. Completely.
But they say
tell them, baby.
They tread lightly.
Completely different.
Tread lightly, Dad. Tread lightly.
But we love each other.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
despite all the breakups, we always come back.
That's how it be.
Love games, baby.
Tread lightly.
Woo.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, the game of love.
So bring it to, you know what I'm saying, another question. As far as what's going on in the world today, you know, we got a lot of, I can say, hatred going on in the world today.
Yeah.
Speaking of love, what do you feel like there's something that we can do as far as to show people that you don't even know
mm-hmm.
love, you know what I'm saying, to make the world a better place than what we
I'm going to tell you what, Darrell, I'm
love
glad you asked
man.
That. Because I was going to say, especially in the times we're in right now,
yeah.
you know, I worry every time my brother, my cousin, my friends, my husband go out the door. I was afraid to have a boy child because of how ridiculous the world is. So we have to uphold each other, love each other, and make you feel safe. When you were saying something about trust, that's it. Trust that you can let it all hang out. You can be right. vulnerable. You can cry if you need to. And right. I'm not going to think of you less as a man.
Okay.
So what we have to do is get away from this mind, this me, especially in our community.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Especially. If we ever get to the point where, how you doing? I see people and I say, how you doing, brother? How you doing, sister? And some people be looking like, well, you spoke to me. Other people be like, how you doing? You
yeah,
know, but that's
yeah.
my personality. But some people, they you got to bring it out because they're skeptical.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's facts. Loving your fellow
right.
people.
I like that.
That's
like that.
Right.
Love your people, man.
I like that
you can't be
like
pissed
that.
Off if somebody be nice.
I like that
if they like, hey, how you doing today? You can't be like, I'm fine. You know what I mean? You gotta be like, you know what? Thank you.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah. And sometimes that love saves people, man.
It does.
You don't know what people going through.
Yeah,
man.
You ever hug somebody and they bust out into tears?
Yes.
Yeah.
With your chest?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
man, give me a hug. All right, man.
Right.
Well, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna switch gears a little bit on you, Mika. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna definitely switch gears on you. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna do something what we call rapid fire. Oh. 10 seconds or less questions.
Rapid
you know?
Okay.
To try
rapid
to get to know you a little
fire.
Bit more on a personal, deeper okay. level. This rapid fire question is brought to you by Cool Geeks. If you want to get your house entertainment on the next level, hit up Cool Geeks. You feel me?
Cool Geeks.
Cool
ATL.
Geeks.
Boy, you hooked me up too, man.
So,
is that with a K or a C?
That's a C.
It's a C. Okay,
that's okay. COOL Geeks. GEEKZ.
Z.
Cool Geeks. Cool. Hit up Cool Geeks.
Cool Geeks.
What up, David?
You want to get an entertainment system? You know what I'm saying? Theater hooked up in your house. TVs hooked on the wall. Security systems.
Yeah.
Hit
oh,
up
wow.
Cool Geeks.
Cool Geeks
do, they
it,
do
all.
It all. They do it all.
That's yeah, what's man. Up. Cool Geeks got a boyfriend and a girl. Man. Cool Geeks.
Man.
So, oh, good. Oh, I'm sorry. Go on.
Good for the business.
Rapid right. fire. So we're going to ask you a few questions. You know okay. what I'm saying? We don't discriminate. We don't hate. Sometimes we may debate. You know what I'm saying? But
rhyming.
But we're going to ask you a question. The first thing that comes to your mind, just answer it without hesitation. Yeah. All right?
Okay.
All right. So I'm going to give you, you know what I'm saying, a little, probably a little, you know what I'm saying, something since we're talking about love.
Okay.
What is your love language?
I have several, but I'm going to go ahead and top them off. 1, 2, 3. Physical touch, quality time, mm-hmm. music. Those are my love languages.
Physical touch, music. Quality time, and music.
Yes.
Okay. That's a good
touch
one.
Me,
that's a good one.
Spend
I like
time
that
with
one.
Me right, and right. play a good ass song.
Touch me in the morning.
favorite Disney movie?
There you go.
Tiana. Because who asked?
Come on.
Oh, the
come on
the
now. Yeah. Yes.
I like
okay.
that.
Okay.
That was lit.
3 habits you want to break.
Oh, shit. Procrastination. Mm. I could be a little tardy sometimes. You know what I'm saying?
Does that kind of go with
tardy.
Procrastination?
A little bit. A little bit. Okay. What's another habit that I could probably break?
Tony, what's some habits we got?
You know, I hate folding clothes. Folding and put away clothes
hold on.
Burns
what's
my
worse?
Ass.
That's a washing, habit. Drying, folding or putting them away.
Folding.
Listen, folding is the worst.
Folding is the worst.
Let me tell you why folding ain't in my category.
No, I hate to put them away.
Throw them in
really?
The clean bin.
I hate to put them away.
That's Talisa. She hate to put them
I
away.
I hate to put them away. Cause once
I hate
them,
to fold
when I'm folding, I'm like, okay, I'm good. But damn, I got to put all this shit that
I'll
I can
be looking
away,
like,
though.
Shit.
I'm cool with putting it away. I don't care for folding.
Yeah, I just throw them in my clean clothes bin.
So folded
for you.
Clean clothes bin.
I don't.
I got the dirty, fresh, I got the clean.
Fresh out the dryer. Yeah. That was hard.
Favorite city you visited?
I don't know. I visited some really good cities. I don't know. I did have a good time in New York. I went to Manhattan.
Okay.
I had a good time
okay.
then.
Okay, least favorite city you visited?
Least favorite. You know, I wasn't really in love with Myrtle Beach. Maybe because
oh, yeah?
I'm not a beach person.
Yeah.
So it was just, eh. You know what I'm saying? It yeah. was all right, you know.
Okay.
Myrtle Beach was
but you
lit.
Know, I can have fun anywhere if the music is right.
There it is. Yeah.
If
there
the
is.
Music is
there
right,
is.
I don't give a damn
don't
if it's
no
just
no good.
Us.
My music.
You know okay. what I mean? The DJ saved my life. Plenty
one
of time.
Must go. Family Matters, Martin, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Jamie Foxx Show. One must go.
I do want to say Family Matters.
Yeah, yeah.
Family Matters.
Did y'all ever really laugh at Family Matters?
No,
not
I laughed
really.
At Steve Urkel.
That was, I appreciate
and
it.
The only time
I
laughed
I
is when he
said it. Was cool.
I watched it faithfully, though.
I did, too.
I mean, I watched
it, was
but
a black family.
Them other shows was funnier.
Yeah.
But, you know, I don't know. Jamie Foxx Show didn't get good to me until he
whoa.
Started singing.
Sherelle said she'd get rid of Jamie Foxx Show.
Yeah, yeah. Sherelle, I was cuz I was tossed
me.
Up between Jamie Foxx and Matt Mathis. I'm going to tell you the truth.
Probably,
Jamie Foxx Show
Family
is my
Matters.
Favorite.
Chasing at
really?
The fancy
yeah.
all the time.
He a singer, actor, comedian.
Right. I love Jamie Foxx.
That's me.
That's why I said it got good when he started singing and he was getting into that
it's,
realm.
It was some funny episodes.
He was singing on the first
you know?
Episode.
Nah.
When he first came.
Like, nah. like the last ones where he was like the jingles.
Right. Yeah, I
that's what I'm saying.
I know every episode
better.
Word for word.
Oh well, you yeah. a little biased.
You a
fan about the shit. You a little biased.
I got you one.
Okay.
Sunrise or sunset?
I'm going to go with the sunset. I'm a real night owl.
Right?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to say Sundays, because God!
If you could bring back any celebrity from the dead, who would it be?
hard. So I can see them in concert. I'm going with Luther.
Luther?
Okay. I'm going to go with Jesus. Come on, baby.
Jesus is a celebrity.
We ready, guy. All of us. We ready.
You come right now. Are you
ready? Let me ask you this.
Are you ready?
Are you going over here? Are you going over there?
While the blood's running warm in your veins.
What you going to tell him? Hold on. Give me 30 more days. Like, what you come on now? I don't know.
Let the PPP loan drop. That's what you say. Take me when the money gone.
That's
God.
What your mouth say, but do your soul say it?
Oh, man. If you could have any celebrity couple on your show, who would you want?
That's a good one, too. Any celebrity couple. I got to think about who would be, like, super fun. I want to, no, they ain't going to be fun. I feel like he ain't going to do shit. And I can relate.
Who?
I wanted to say Beyonce and Jay-Z because I like Jay-Z, both of them.
He'll do stuff.
I don't know. He looked like a real lay in the cut.
You know, I'm
really going to say Will and Jada.
No.
Because I love Will Smith. Yeah. Well,
that episode going to be in September with the singles.
Right.
Real, this is the more people.
Switch!
Yeah, this is the situationship season. Everybody with a situationship. You know, got three or more. Come along.
I think Snoop Dogg and his wife. Because his whole little family, they funny as hell.
Yeah.
Okay, I got one. The worst person to have around your man. Portia Williams.
Okay.
Fantasia.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Alicia Keys.
Uh-huh.
Cousin Faith from Soul Food. Cousin Ebony from Players Club.
Cousin Evans, these bitch ass. First of all, my husband don't like her. Still, from to this day.
Damn.
And she reckless because she don't really know what the hell she doing. So she just doing all of the things.
Okay.
Oh, man.
She let the money make
sneaky this. With it though.
Yes, yeah. But she just needed a little understanding. Oh, that's all she was like the black sheep.
You
so
don't
she
understand
just,
out the.
You know what I'm saying?
At least she keep a smile and sing in your face though. If you don't.
Hey, that he was one foot out the door because I don't believe people can take your man.
Okay.
I don't believe people can take your man.
Okay.
He was already ready to go.
He was already ready to go. You're
he was
right.
Packed.
He was already ready to go.
All he needed was, already opportunity. That's
what
right.
Made you say Fantasia? I don't
know. Didn't Fantasia tell you somebody? All right.
She did.
Yeah.
Fuck, marry, kill.
Okay. Close your ears, Lee.
Lorenz Tate.
Okay.
Amari Hardwick.
Uh-huh.
Chris Brown.
Killing the hell out of Amari. Okay, he a little funny
Ghost?
Looking to me. He a little funny looking to me.
Amari or
oh,
Ghost?
Oh.
Which one did you have?
Chris Brown can get it today.
Damn.
And I would marry Lorenz Tate.
Damn.
I love Darius.
That was the quickest answer.
Everybody else on me.
Everybody was like,
Brown,
damn.
Chris everybody who knows me know Chris Brown is my man.
You must have had this question asked.
Damn.
No, but
she
I do know the
it.
Answer. And
just,
I love
just in case
so that, so,
know.
So that answered the celebrity crush question. So, bop. Don't get that out.
Okay, I'll take it. I'll deal with it.
Do you believe Bigfoot is real?
No.
So do you believe in aliens?
Do I believe in what?
Aliens. You think aliens
no.
are real? You think we the only ones out here?
I think that's the name I got that business and I ain't gonna worry about no bullshit. That's what I think.
Hey, you're gonna have a conversation when you get back home tonight.
That's
all right. I know, because y'all are total opposite.
You're gonna have a conversation when you get
back. He know we total opposite. He'll tell you himself.
No. About to fuck, marry, kill. You're gonna have a conversation when you get home tonight.
Listen, I'm gonna come in the house playing Chris Brown.
Chris Brown?
Huh? I'm gonna come in the house with his song.
You just say Chris Brown, leave that Chris Breeze. You said. Today. So that's how you feel, huh?
You was real passionate about that one, wasn't you?
Baby, turn it's on it's private it. Show for when you I get home.
You gonna be at home dancing. Fine.
Finish this sentence. I love it when.
Oh, shit.
That's it?
When I get paid. Like, in regards to what?
Okay.
I love it when I get paid.
Okay.
You know.
Okay. Describe the perfect date. If you were single and you getting to know somebody, first date, perfect first date.
Okay, the perfect date for me, we are going to see some live music, right? We got some live music, we got some drinks, it's comfortable.
Okay.
I ain't got to put on a shoe for real. I can wear sneakers and
like
jeans.
Comfort. Okay.
Yes, it's very easy and chill. Nothing too fancy and stuffy, but that music got to be
You got to have that music.
I got to.
So you can't get with somebody that's like in a total different music genre.
That's talking about that.
Well,
shout it. You take it to Garth Brooks or something, you're going to be like,
And I mean, I like lots of different music, but yeah.
Okay. What up, Robin?
I will side-eye him.
Wow. One last question for you before we go to this break.
Okay.
What's one love movie that you can watch all the time?
Love Jones!
Oh, I already knew that.
Didn't I tell you? Lorenz?
Penny with a hole in it.
Yeah. Yes.
I thought you would have said Love and Basketball.
No. I mean, I like Love and Basketball, but Love Jones, first of all, the soundtrack.
It wasn't that soundtrack.
That soundtrack was
the music. The music gotta be on point.
And then the poem he said at the very beginning.
I ain't never seen Love.
Oh my goodness! What? Hold on! Stop another the press! Hold on! Stop the press!
What the hell?
Stop the press! Did this nigga just say? Said
it. Oh my god!
This nigga just said he ain't never watched. Love.
Hold on, you got it.
Give me back your card. Let me have it.
Listen. Love Jones came out, what, 94, 95? 95.
I was three.
He was born in 91.
That don't mean shit.
I didn't watch it when it first came out.
Me either. That don't mean shit.
Well, we was only, what, 11? We weren't knowing about no I Love Jones at 11 years old.
I was good and into women around that time.
I'm gonna watch it though, you guys.
You got to listen to the soundtrack.
I'm gonna watch it tonight.
The poem at the very beginning, pay close attention to the words.
Okay.
Well, hey, we gonna take a quick break on Big Talk Big Game, man. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna come right back, man, in a couple minutes, man. Sheesh. Once again, so this ashamed. Is Big Talk.
Go get your ass an apple game. Pie and come back.
Yo, we back in the building, man. Big Talk Big Game is definitely back in the building. You feel me?
Uh-huh.
We appreciate y'all staying with us or whatnot. And this, you know what I'm saying? That during that commercial break. Like I said, that was Cool Geeks. If you ever want to get a home theater system put in your crib, you want to get some cameras put around your crib to watch it at all times mobily, or if you want to just get a TV hung on the wall or anything like a camera on your doorbell, definitely hit up Cool Geeks. That's Cool Geeks with a C. You feel me?
Great service.
Yeah. Uh-huh. So we got Mr. Lee Rankin coming up right now, man. We definitely gonna say gonna get right into it, man. So we definitely gonna say gonna bring that on in here. You feel me, Mr. Lee's Rankin.
Rankin,
what's up, man?
Rankin with L-E-E Lee. We working on things over here, y'all. So once again, as in each and every Thursday when we try to fit it in, the Rankin is just a little segment to get to know each other, to get to know our guests or whatever, to get to know y'all. So feel free to call in to us about anything we talk about on the show, but including the Rankin. If you want to call in, that number is
404-603-0414.
Anyway. All right, so this is where we take a couple items and we have everybody rank them in order of best or worst, depending on whatever it is the hell I'm talking about.
Okay.
So Mother's Day just passed.
And since we're talking about love, it's nothing like a mother's love, right?
Always love my mama.
So outside of Dear Mama and A Song for Mama by Boys to Men, I got a couple songs about mamas that I want y'all to rank the best mama song.
Okay.
Y'all hear me?
Yes.
Am I plugged
the
in?
The best mama song.
I'm a mama.
Yeah, so shout out to all the mamas. Hope everybody had an excellent Mother's Day. And we gonna get into it. Y'all ready? Here go one.
Come on, man. And with the local DBC.
Mama said knock you out. I tell you what. Don't call it a comeback.
I've been here for years. I'm rocking my pants. Foot suffers in fear. Making the tears rain down like a monsoon. Listen to the bass girl boom. Explosion. Overpowering.
That's the first song. Mama saying not you out.
When I drop these lyrics that I make you
again, these aren't the cliche mama song.
Here
go the next one.
Change her ringtone.
It's my baby mama.
Yeah.
She be riding caddy. And she always looking
what?
For sugar daddy.
Let's get it.
It's my baby daddy.
What do you worry about that?
Nothing but a joke. It's my baby daddy.
Memphis, what up?
Nothing heavy.
All right, that's song three.
Okay. That's my idea.
Song four.
Man, this freak is got.
Man, I know this. I saw mama.
I can't stand this.
Song.
I saw mama sleeping with Santa Claus.
So,
mama at that. She kissed herself.
Y'all know this song, man. Y'all hear it around December song.
I wonder how Joe Jackson felt about
this. When last time y'all heard this song in May?
Ever.
All right.
I don't never have
one more song. You know what? A lot of y'all might not know this song. This is the last one.
Here we go.
Forget the ring.
A lot of y'all won't know this
song.
Write
it down.
First one was Mama Said Knock You Out. Second one was Hey Ma. Third one is My Baby Mama. Fourth one, I Just Saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus. This is a bonus one. You can include this or not. Y'all probably don't know this. Because some of y'all kind of young. I'm gonna whoever wrote this hook.
To rush to get old.
It's a long ass intro. I had to fast forward.
Yeah, it is.
Back in the day, that's how they used to
be. The intro used to be 4 minutes long before birthday.
Mama used to say, take your time, young man. Mama used to say,
what?
Don't you rush to get old. Mama used to say,
cheer.
To get in your stride.
Mama
used to say, live your life.
Yeah, get up there.
Live your life.
Rank them.
That was amazing. I forgot. One more time.
All right, so we got Mama Said Knock You Out.
That's number one for me.
Hey Ma, it's my baby mama.
That's number two.
I Saw Mama Kissing Santa Claus.
That's last.
And Mama used to say,
which one was, it's my baby mama? Which one was that? Number three?
That's, yeah. So, yeah, just whatever in order. So, Mika, first one you got is My Baby Mama. That's what you're saying?
No. Mama used to say is my first one.
Really?
Okay.
And what was what was the one before It's My Baby Mama?
Hey Ma.
Yeah.
That Hey Ma my number one.
That's my number two.
Hey Ma.
What's up?
Hey Ma is my number
two. That's my number one.
Me too.
And we're gonna get it on tonight.
I'll tell you who lasts. Mama's
kissing Santa Claus. Right, that's definitely my last two.
Yeah.
Mom, I saw Mama kissing Santa Claus. Definitely number laugh. Five.
Terrible.
Number two, I would probably say, it's my baby mama.
Yeah, you know.
Oh, child support.
Uh-huh.
She can get welfare checks, but I stay in cool. It's my baby mama.
Yeah, you know.
She be always broke.
And she always hard.
For sure, get
that. So that's your number two.
That's my number two. Mama said knock you out is number three. And then what was the other one?
I don't know no more.
Shit, I saw Mama kissing Santa Claus.
No, that was five.
Mama used to say.
That's number four. There we go.
Well, everybody said that melody was off, so go. That's why.
You got to have the music on.
Oh my God, you got that.
All right, there so next rank them. That was fun. Next one, a little bit deeper.
Okay.
All right, since we're talking about love, I want y'all to rank the items that, what y'all argue about, bump heads about.
Oh, shit.
The most.
I'm going to need some more paper.
The most thing y'all bump heads about. This is real general. I ain't going to get too specific.
Okay.
Ready? Money.
Right?
Money and finances.
Okay.
Y'all argue about it? Okay. Household chores.
Yeah, most definitely.
Okay.
Because if I cook, I ain't doing the dishes.
How about this one? Parenting decisions.
Oh, that's the one.
That's my number
What's
one.
It? Number two?
That's three. Number three. Number we got three. Money.
Money.
Household chores. Parenting decisions.
That's the one.
That's number one.
Let that little boy go on over there to that one of them.
One.
Time management.
Man.
Where are you spending your time? You ain't spending enough time with me. You always here. You always there. Bring your ass home. Da 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 da.
Touching on some toes on that one.
Romantic intimacy.
That's the one.
Ooh, romance. You ain't never did nothing.
You don't never want to help me.
Why you don't do that? The other old guy did. Romantic intimacy.
Why you don't do that?
And last one, jealousy. D-hole out here, boy.
Oh, okay. So,
showing
up. You got to write down because I didn't forget already.
Y'all ready? I named one. Okay. Money. Household chores. Maybe I got too many. Time management. Romantic intimacy. Parenting decisions. Rank them!
Well, parenting decisions is definitely my number one.
Really?
That's my number one off rip parenting decisions. Let's see here. Yeah, it was six of them. It was six.
Okay.
It was six.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I got it now. I got it. Thank you.
Let me look at it. I'm going to rank mine first. So, I'm going to say, like I said, parenting decisions is number one.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to start cutting these down.
Time management is probably number two.
Time management.
It's probably number two. That's probably number two. I ain't going to lie to you. It's probably number two.
Sherelle says smart mouth is my number one. Damn.
Sherelle, you know your
let's
family.
Let's see here.
How she gonna say that?
These hoes exes are jealous. That's probably number three.
Ooh.
That's number three.
Jealous.
I'll probably jealous. Say. Let's see here. I still got three more.
Show gonna be sketchy at the
house. I'll probably say just money. I'll probably say money is number four.
You just do your top three.
I'll probably say.
As he continues.
Right.
I'll probably say. Shit.
Shit. Y'all always shitting.
I'll probably say romantic intimacy is number five and household chores is number six. That's my thing. That's my thing.
I can't wait to hear the other side of that.
Number one is household chores. That's, listen.
Really?
Boy, we bump heads on the household
chores.
But that's the funny thing about relationships, man.
Listen.
On who do the most, who not doing the most.
Who ain't doing, who shit. Is
this
doing.
This sound like there's some issues over there, boy.
Listen.
Y'all need a talent chart.
He had to say that three times. Them household chores.
We be good until it's time. As
soon as it's time to wash clothes, y'all got an attitude.
I see you nodding off over there. Them dishes still in the sink.
We just ain't gonna vacuum the floor.
I ain't trying to be your daddy or nothing, but
so you ain't gonna do nothing till I say so.
I don't think these boys old enough to get out there and watch them dish. So household chores definitely number one.
We got that.
But then parenting decisions.
That's number
my
two.
Lord, my Lord, my Lord.
See, I started not to put that.
Because
like,
she a PK. She a preacher kid. And I've been in these streets.
Okay.
So I discipline conflicts all the time.
I've been saying it before.
Do you got to whoop them? Yes! How else these niggas? I got to whoop them all the damn time.
Right.
Wow. Look how I turned that. Perfectly fine.
She be like, good enough for you.
So,
and what's the number three?
Number three, romantic intimacy.
Oh. Okay.
So and I say that three. I say that just because I get hot fast. And my wife be one. Can you hold me? I'm going to hold you. But can we... can we cut the air on? While
I got one more, and then we done with the rankings.
Okay.
Oh, we ain't seen her.
Yeah, we
ain't
seen her.
Oh, yeah, go ahead. I'm
just going to start at the bottom. The last thing we going to argue about is money.
Yeah, okay. Us too.
Mine is very good with the money. We got no problems. Okay. Number one is romance. Number one.
She went from last to one.
You got to hug and kiss before you slap. Okay? The hug and the kiss. Here go the slap. Romantic intimacy is number one. Time management is probably number two.
Ooh, okay.
You know,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
We Man. Have no problem.
I just started some discussions.
With the money. But
time. All right, last one. Since we went to the negative, last one, positive. The best, we're going to get a little mushy. Emotional trait for your significant other. It's not as many. We got ability to let go. Meaning you ain't holding no grudges. You ain't got no abandonment issues. You okay letting shit go.
Okay,
yeah,
okay.
We finna go apply for these love games. That's what
Come on.
Selflessness.
Okay.
Putting yourself last for your mate, for your other.
Okay. Yeah.
Mothers really good at this. They got that selflessness in them. You know what I'm saying? That nurture.
Yeah.
The third one.
They both do.
Empathy for others. Like your consideration. I guess that kind of falls in selflessness. We'll just throw that under selflessness.
Okay.
So last one. Security, meaning you're secure, you're confident, you're not crazy, jealous, you're comfortable with yourself.
Yeah.
Got them? So those are the three. Ability to let go, your selflessness, and your security in your significant other. The best traits. Because, you know, I don't know about y'all, but when I was, when I'm courting.
When I was a
And I'm scoping out in my mind. I'm an analytical person. I'm analyzing if this the person I want to be with. I look at how they treat other people. Man, you know what I'm saying?
True.
If we at the restaurant and the order get messed up, how crazy you gonna act? Because eventually I'm gonna get some of this negativity. Right now we cool. You know what I'm saying? Well, people don't be looking at it. They be like, oh, she cute, she fine. Oh, he look good. Oh, he provide. But what about how they treat motherfuckers? Because eventually that's going to be your ass when they upset.
Right. Yeah, right. True.
You know what I'm saying?
It's true.
Also, how they act when you looking and you around and y'all dating, y'all see other people or whatever. How jealousy, how secure they are with themselves, how confident they are. You know what I'm saying? That plays a factor.
Sneak peek.
Yeah.
Until.
Because also how they treat others is kind of like how you going to parent a little bit. Your selflessness. How you gonna deal with other things? Cause you know, most time you don't think about this person as a parent until that slip up happens and you get that call.
Ah, damn, slip up
when you get that.
Damn, it ain't planned.
I think I'm late text. what you don't want that late text. I think I'm late text.
Please know, there's several discussions with her own self before you got that text.
Exactly. So just exactly. Know. Just know. I know. Yeah, and probably a couple friends.
Do we too. Even tell you? Because exactly. I don't know about
See, that's the yes. See, that's what I'm talking about.
So, do I want him to be the father? That's the other talk they have.
Yeah.
Rank him!
That's a whole nother
show.
Ain't it?
Right.
Call
right.
me on that.
Right. Hey, call us up with any of this
call
information.
Call us, man. The number here, man, is 404.
603.
0414.
Once again, the number is 404.
603.
0414. Rank them, y'all.
Here we go.
Think? Okay, we got the ability to let go.
Okay.
This is in your significant other. You might think about yourself, but this is their ability to let go.
So this is something that they're doing to us.
This is your favorite trait or your the trait that you hold most high, that you're ranking.
Okay, okay.
When you look ability to let go.
Mine is her selflessness.
Selflessness and...
No, it's about you.
Yeah, right? And
me?
Security.
What you hold yourself up to out of them three.
Well, no, it's your favorite...
Trait about them.
And your significant other that they have.
Oh, that they have. Oh, okay.
Yeah. That they bring into your relationship.
I would say selflessness is definitely number one for me.
Okay.
Okay. You love that about your significant other.
That's selflessness. Yeah. What was the last one again?
Selflessness, ability to let go, and security.
How secure
they are with themselves.
I would say ability to let go is number two, and then security is number three.
Okay.
It's different for me.
Yeah.
The security number two, and the ability to let go is dead ass last.
Damn.
It be some shit, huh? No, because you remember you.
Some people ain't gonna let that go.
That's what I'm saying. Cause I got that trait.
Yeah.
Because I ain't got butterfingers. If you know, you know.
Oh, hey, hey.
Don't bring that up. We got.
That's in my back pocket, baby. I'll let you know after this.
We got to let family know. You can't handle inside.
I'll let y'all lay it on that butterfinger, Joe.
So, what was your ability to let go was last?
That's last. Dead last. Wanted to drop it, but I couldn't. So, it's dead last.
Woo! Meek on that note.
I can't wait to meet her. I can't wait.
Shit, love to come to the love, dude. We explore.
I think I'm gonna go because now that you have re-explained, okay, yeah. I'm gonna go with selflessness is number one.
Okay. Okay. I can see that.
I can see that. He's selfless. Last, let's just let go. Okay, was it four or three?
Three. It was three.
Okay, so security would be right in the middle.
Yeah. Okay.
Right in the middle.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Same list.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
What about you, Lee?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, interesting.
We all getting whoopings when we get home.
Selflessness.
Definitely.
I'm getting folks in trouble. Selflessness. Damn. Selflessness and security are pretty high on the list for me. That damn ability to let go. Because like you said, you know, we played each other's strip. I got the ability to let go. We got an
honor. Me too.
I'm joking 2 seconds later. She's still mad. Oh, not yet. Too soon.
I'm the same way.
I'm
like, oh, we still mad?
Oh,
my bad. Because I forgot.
I'm going to hit a block.
I forgot. I said it. We done.
I'm immediately done.
Okay.
So, like, my selflessness, you know, like, she always putting, sometimes that can be a fault. Because, ladies, men, take care of yourself, too.
Yeah.
Don't be too involved with, you know, everybody else.
Yeah.
Selflessness number
That's
one.
That's true.
Yeah.
Security, I mean, the confidence and all that, man, that's number two. And then, that ability to let go.
That let go is just
that
tough.
Shit there.
Hey. But damn, that was 2 years ago.
Ryan,
I don't know.
Ryan, what a super my goddamn juice.
It's people that don't ever let go.
That's true.
This show is.
They don't ever
let go. Hey, let the shit go.
Let go and let God.
Right.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. We'll have you letting go.
Well, that's the leading ranker, man. Now, before we get out of this, you know what I'm saying, for today, man, comes one of my favorite, and I know Lee has said it the other week or whatnot, one of my favorite times of the show. It's called If This Versus Was to Happen.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Love it.
If This Versus Was to Happen. So today's contest is going to be between buckle your seatbelts.
Oh, shit.
I'm ready.
It's going to be between Sierra.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
And Carrie Hilson.
That's
a nice little Sierra thing. And Carrie Hilson.
If this was to happen,
who would you pick? So before we play the songs,
Sierra,
who you picking?
I don't know about that match.
Ain't both of them from Atlanta?
They both from Atlanta.
Who you picking right now? Sierra and Carrie Hilson.
I know a lot of Carrie Hilson.
You say you picking who? He picking Carrie Hilson.
I got Sierra.
I got Sierra too.
I got Sierra too.
You got?
Sierra, man.
So we got four Sierras.
Because Sierra said she ain't never had nobody love her. I don't think that she done told her in a better way. She, you know,
so here's song number one.
That is the truth.
In a breath. Here's song number one by, see, now these are random songs.
And 1-2 steps. Just.
Here's song number one by Sierra.
My goodies,
okay,
my first song,
I got my sick reputation for handling bros. All I need is me a few seconds and more, then it's a wrap. Double A to bring my lap, and I ain't coming back, so you can put a car right there. I'm the truth, and I ain't got nothing to prove. And you can ask anybody, cause they seen me do it. Barricades, I run right through them, used to. Throw all the dirt you want, no use. Still won't have a pen up in a fabulous room. Bone her back, picking out a basket of fruit.
I love you, bro.
Yeah, freaking Petey, love you too. You know how I do it.
Don't knock the power out.
That cherry here is good. There's no song one, man.
Yeah. 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 Yeah
song number three by Sierra. Oh. Song number three by Terry Hilton.
Don't turn me on.
We definitely want to shout out Miss Mika Turnage for coming through.
Yeah.
Mika, once again, tell the people how they can be a part of Love Game and how they can find you.
All right. The website and the IG are the same. Love Games, LoveGames 777.com for the website. You can call me 678-463-9058. And I see you on the field.
All right.
Yeah.
Special shout out to my boy Nelson Trimble, the Popular Lane Clothing. You already know.
There it is. Hey, man, once again, man, this is Big Talk, Big Game.
Uh-huh.
We're here every Thursday from 7 to 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, man. Uh-huh. So tune in. And like we always say, man, share it to anybody you know or anybody that you don't know.
Spread the love.
Spread the love.
Spread the love.
Hey, love. Spread the love. This is your boy, D-Rail.
Eat Cal.
And I go by the name of Lee. What up?
Hey, man, we out of here, man. Peace.
Switch music in the-